Hi everyone, welcome y'all. In the today's video, we are going to see a few important questions which are related to browser cookies. Like how to capture cookies from the browser and how to print cookies details. Then we'll see how to add cookies to the browser and then how can delete a specific cookie from the browser. Then finally, we'll see how to delete all the cookies from the browser. So before doing this, we need to understand what is a cookie or what are the cookies. So cookies are basically a temporary files which is which are created by the browser. And when you browsing some data on through browser, so suppose when you're trying to visit some website and your browser will automatically save some information in the cookies files. They are basically temporary internet files. And after sometimes you can delete those files or sometimes it will automatically delete it. So the cookies are the temporary files which are created by the browser when you visiting some kind of website. And sometimes we need to test whether those cookies are properly creating and properly deleting or not. So as part of the testing. Now, Selenium web driver is provided a certain number of methods and by which we can test our cookies. Now, first of all, let us see what are those methods are available. And then we will see practically how we can use those methods. So there are some methods are available called manage.getCookies. And through driver instance, we can access these methods. So like manage.getCookies. So this is a method which will return all the cookies which are generated by the browser and which will return the list of all the cookies. Now manage.addCookie. So here we have to pass the cookie object and which will create a new cookie to the browser. And manage.deleteCookie. So this particular command or method which will delete the cookie. And the next one is delete cookie name. So here we have to pass the name of the cookie, then it will automatically delete that particular cookie. And the main difference between these two methods are delete cookie method will take a cookie object and accordingly it will delete the cookie. But here delete cookie name, here we can pass direct name of the cookie and accordingly that specific cookie will be deleted. Now, if you want to delete all the cookies from the browser, we can use delete all cookies. So these are the few methods which are provided by Selenium WebDriver. Now let us see one by one how we can use practically and also we'll see how we can answer these questions. Now let's go back to the Eclipse and here I'm just created one new Maven project in the pom.xml. We already have two dependencies. One is Selenium Java dependency. The other one is WebDriver manager. Now go back to my package and inside this I'm creating a new class. To demonstrate cookies, I'm just creating a new class. I'll name it as cookies demo, or we can simply say handling cookies. Okay, now I'll try to answer all these questions in with some one example. Now handling cookies, let's take a main method here and say finish. All right, so now we created a new class called handling cookies. The first thing is we need to set up the browser. So for that, I'm using WebDriver manager. I say WebDriver manager dot and Chrome driver dot setup. I'm using Chrome browser. And once you have done this, we need to create a driver instance. So for that, I say WebDriver and driver equal to new Chrome driver. So new Chrome driver. This is a lowercase character. Right, so now we have to import this Chrome driver class and also web driver interface. So now we have created driver instance and accordingly we have to launch our application. So here I'm using one application. Let's go back to the browser, open it, demo.nocommerce.com. So I'll just try to work with the cookies of this particular application browser. So next, let's go to the code and driver.get. And here I'm passing the URL of application. And then what you can do is as soon as you launch your application. So the first thing is, let us see how to capture cookies from the browser. As soon as you browse this particular page, immediately your browser will save the cookies information in the temporary files. Now let us see how to capture those files, how to capture the cookies files. So let's see the first one, how to capture cookies from the browser. That's the first operation. How to capture cookies from the browser. So for that, we have a method called driver.manage.getCookies. Get cookies. So this is a method. And this particular method, getCookies, will return set of cookie object, because there are multiple cookies will be there and we have to store them in a collection. So set is a collection which is used from Java. And in the set, all cookies are cookie type. Okay, so the return type will be like this. So return type is set of, in the angular bracket, we have to say cookie. Cookie is an object. So here we say cookies. Now this is an instance variable which I have created. Now we have to import this set collection from java.util, and cookie is, we have to import the cookies from Selenium. So cookie we have to import from Selenium properly. So if I just look at here, org.openqueue.selenium. So this is the right package which you have to select, because there are so many other packages also, cookie class is available. So import this. So now what this statement will do is, this will get all the cookies from your browser and store all of them in this variable. Okay. Now let us see how many cookies have been created. So for that, what you can do is take this variable dot, there is a method called size. That's it. So this will give you how many cookies have been captured. So let us try to print this value, system.out.println. And here I can say size of cookies. All right. So now let us see how many cookies have captured, and I'm just printing it. And not only the size, I just want to print the information about the cookies, like name of the cookie and values. So every cookie is having certain attributes like name, value, expiry date, and so on. So we can capture those values also. So let me just capture them also, then we will run it. So how to print cookies from browser? That means how to capture the details of the cookies. That's the next thing. How to print cookies from the browser means we can capture the name of the cookies and value of the cookies. So for that, what we have to do is we need to read all the cookies from this variable, because we already captured the cookies into this variable. So we need to get those cookies from this variable. So for that, I'm just writing one for each loop. And here I specify this cookies. And from this cookies, I just read each and every cookie. So I'm just creating one variable here. Let's say cookie. And what is the type of this variable is? Cookie type. The type of the variable is cookie. So from the cookies variable, I'm extracting each and every cookie into this variable. Now the type of variable should be cookie. So cookie is a predefined class. Okay. Now from this cookie variable, we can extract the details of the cookie, like name of the cookie, value of the cookie, expiry date, and so on. Now let me print here. So let's say cookie dot. And these are the different details, like say get domain, get expiry date, name, path, value. So many things are there. So let me first get the name of the cookie. So cookie dot get name. I'm just printing that. So cookie dot get name and concatenation. And also I want to print cookie dot get value, value of the cookie. Similarly, you can extract all the details. So I want to just format it. First, I will print cookie name, concatenation, and then I will give concatenation with some space I'm giving. And inside this, I'll put colon. Okay. So here first it will print the name of the cookie, and here it will print the value of the cookie. All right. So now this particular loop will read each and every cookie from this variable, store that in the variable, and we are getting the details about the cookie. So name of the cookie, value of the cookie. So what exactly we have done in these steps? First, we have captured all the cookies from the browser, and we found the size of the cookies, how many cookies have been created. And then we read each and every cookie from this variable into this one. And by using this cookie variable, I'm extracting the name of the cookie and value of the cookie. Now let us try to execute, run as Java application. Now let's try to execute. Okay, now it is launched my website. I'm just closing it. Now observe this output. So size of the cookies. Total how many cookies have been created? 5 cookies have captured at the runtime. And what are they? So this is a cookie name, this is a value. And this is another cookie name, this is a value. This is another cookie name, value. How many have created? 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Exactly 5 cookies have been created. All right, so this is how we can capture all the cookies from the browser and we can extract the data from the cookies. Now the next thing is how to add a cookie and how to delete the cookie. And these things we can do by using methods. So let me show you how to add a cookie to the browser. So how to add a cookie to the browser. So for that, what you have to do is we have to use one more method called addCookie. This is a method which I have to use. AddCookie method we have to use. So before that, what you have to do is we need to create some cookie object. So for example, let's take a cookie and cookie obj, cookie object reference variable I'm creating for cookie class. And here I'll say new cookie. And here we have to specify the name of the cookie and the value of the cookie. And here I'm specifying the name of the cookie as I say my cookie 123, some different name you can give. And here this is a value I'm providing 123456. So some value I'm providing. So this is the name of the cookie and this is the value of the cookie. And now this particular object we have to use along with this method, add cookie method. So now let me add it. I say driver.manage.addCookie, and here we have to pass this cookie object. That's it. So this new cookie will be added to the existing cookie. So this cookie, we have added our own cookie through our automation script. Okay. So previously we have only five cookies have been created here, right? We have printed five cookies, but here I'm adding my own cookie and now it should become six cookies, right? Now we'll see the count again. So to see the count, once we added our new cookie, the cookie value will be the six. So how we can again count it? Again, we have to copy this code. So again, we have to capture all the cookies into this variable one more time. And then size of the cookies after adding. So again, we are printing the cookie size. Here, what could be the size now? It should be six. Now let us execute one more time. So after adding the cookie, we have to capture all the cookies one more time. And then only we will get the final total number of cookies. So initially it is a five. After adding one more cookie, then it should become six. Now let us see how it is going to work. And after doing everything, I'm also closing my browser. I say driver.quit or you can use close. Now let us run one more time. All right, so now my Chrome driver started successfully launching my browser and closed my browser. So now you can just look at here. Initially, total number of cookies are five, which is captured. We have printed all the cookies information here. Now we have added a new cookie. So it has become six now. Size of the cookies after adding. Okay, so this is how we have to do this. So first of all, we need to create a cookie object and where we have to pass name of the cookie and value of the cookie into the constructor. Then we use one method called driver.manage.addCookie. Here we have to pass a cookie object. Then which will automatically add a new cookie to the browser. Then we can capture all the cookies and we can find the size of the cookies. Now we'll see the next one. Suppose we already added one cookie, then I want to delete that particular cookie. So how we can delete it? So to delete this cookie, what you have to do is we can use, we have two methods are available. Either we can use delete cookie or we can use delete cookie named. But when you use delete cookie method, we have to pass the cookie object. Okay, when you use delete cookie named, here we have to pass the name of the cookie. Now I'll show you the difference. So the first we'll use first method. So I want to delete the cookie, whatever cookie which you have added here, I want to delete it. So for that, what you have to do is we have a method called driver.manage.deleteCookie. So when I say delete cookie, we have to pass the object, whatever cookie object we created, which contains the cookie, and that we will delete here. driver.manage.deleteCookie and cookie object we have to pass. So this will automatically delete the cookie. Right, so after deleting this cookie, again, I want to capture all the cookies and again, I want to print the cookies. So after deleting the cookie, I'm again capturing it and I'm again printing it. How many cookies now it should be? Again, it should become 5. Because initially 5 cookies are there. And after that, we have added one more cookie. Then it becomes a 6. Now I am deleting that cookie, whichever I created here, I'm just deleting that cookie. Then again, it should becomes a 5. Now size of the cookies after deletion. Now let us try to execute and see. Now it is launched my browser, opening my application. Now it is closed. Now you can see size of the cookies are 5 initially. Then it becomes a 6 after adding one cookie. Then after deleting one cookie, it becomes again 5. So this is a way we can delete the cookie. And there is one more way to delete the cookie by using this method, delete cookie named. Now let us try to use that method now. I'll comment this. I say driver.manage.deleteCookieNamed. But if I want to use this method, we have to pass the name of the cookie. So this is a name, right? So that we have to specify. Instead of specifying the cookie object, we have to specify the name of the cookie, whichever you want to delete. Now this particular method will delete the particular cookie. Now let us try to execute one more time. All right, so now it is done. So you can see initially 5, after adding it becomes 6. Now after deletion, it becomes a 5. So successfully deleted. So we can pass either cookie object by using delete cookie method, or we can use delete cookie named method where we have to specify the name of the cookie. And now suppose I have all the cookies. Now I want to delete all the cookies. Let's say 5 cookies already there. So I want to delete all the cookies. So then how we can do that? So how to delete all the cookies from the browser? So to delete all the cookies from the browser, it's very simple. And we can use this method. I say driver.manage.deleteAllCookies. Delete all cookies. So this particular method will delete all the cookies from the browser, right? So after that, again, I'm capturing all the cookies. I'm trying to print it. It should return 0 now. Our expectation is 0. So after deleting all the cookies, again, I'm trying to capture the cookies from the browser. It should return 0. So the size should be 0 finally. Now let us try to execute and see. So Chrome driver started successfully, launched my browser. All right, so done. So now you can see here, initially 5, then we have added one cookies, it becomes a 6. Now we have deleted that cookie, again it becomes 5. Now finally we have deleted all the cookies, so it becomes 0 now. Okay, so this is how we can work with the cookies. We can do different type of operations on browser level cookies. And the cookies are the temporary files which are created by the browser while visiting the web pages. And these cookies information not always standard. Okay, it becomes changed. Initially, every time when you run, it is giving only 5. Sometimes it will be 7 or sometimes it will be 10. Okay, so this is how we need to test the cookies, whether the create cookies are properly creating the browser or not. And we are able to delete the cookies or not. And we are able to add a new cookies or not. And we can also capture the information from the cookies. So by using get name, get value, right? So these are the different things we can test on cookies. And for that, Selenium WebDriver is provided these methods. Get cookies, add cookie, delete cookie name, and delete all the cookies. Okay. So that is all about handling cookies using Selenium WebDriver. All right. So that's all for this video, guys. In the next video, we'll see a few more questions. Thanks for watching.